After a few requests, I now make a little video about my XY scope vector plotter that can plot all sorts of logos, graphics, and cool things on your analog oscilloscopes in XY mode. So here's my solution, and if you Google a little bit on this topic, you'll be able to find quite a lot of solutions. Most of them contain a lot less hardware compared to what I have to show you here. And there's actually quite a lot of reasons why I made it this complicated. As you see here, I am using two 8-bit DA converters. So the 8-bit from one port goes directly into all the 8 input bits of this AD converter. It's an AD558KN. So it's a really, really good, super nice and linear AD converter. And it also contains an internal bandgap reference. So that means zero output is 0 volts, and 255, that is the highest value, that is 2.56 volts. Plus minus the little bit of minor error, right? So the two ports here, this is how you can do it the fastest way possible. And I want speed, because if you just use a normal Arduino and use the PWM outputs, you can definitely make two analog outputs using PWM, just a resistor and a capacitor, and then you can draw very, very simple logos, and just 10, 20, 50 points, and then still going to flicker because of the PWM filters you need to add before you have a stable analog voltage per point you want to update. And I really don't want this flicker, and also I want much more complicated logos. So this is why I'm going for speed. So the logo that I make, or the logo that I use in many of my videos, that is nearly 4,000 points. And I can update this 200 to 300 times per second. So that is actually, if you calculate this back to kilobytes per second, it's about 800 and something kilobytes per second this unit delivers. But that is, of course, because it's 8-bit and 8-bit, and then I clock them in perfect sync. See, here is a synchronization or latch input to the two DA converters. And that is also very, very important, because you want the two dots to come at exactly the same time. Otherwise, you move from one point to another point, not on a straight line between the points, but either one horizontal or the vertical output comes before the other one. So depending on how you're moving around in your graphics, you're not going to have a nice and straight line. So that is also solved in this hardware here. Also, the output from the two DA converters, that is a positive voltage. And if you just take the output directly from the DA converter via a resistor and a capacitor, this is of course my D alias, or my low pass filter. So this this filter goes and make the removes the single dots, for example. If you just take this signal here before all the op amps and all that kind of stuff here directly to an oscilloscope, here's an analog oscilloscope, that will be perfectly fine. Because analog oscilloscopes, you have a position, and you can of course gain the signal, and you can move the signal in the XY modes. So you don't really need a 0-volt sensored output if this is what you want to achieve. However, I use this logo creator for all sorts of stuff, not only oscilloscopes, but anything that contains a CRT and all sorts of funny amplifiers for the deflection. Sometimes I even need to pull out a tube and feed in a differential signal to drive the deflection. So that means, of course, I need both the normal positive signal and then the inverted signal at the same time, both for the vertical and for the horizontal outputs. I also included a little bit variable level, but it's all explained in this schematic. So have a look at the schematic. It also shows how I create the negative reference. I only use two series diodes, and the perfect voltage will be minus 1.27 volts. That is halfway to full scale. And that means, of course, now my new sensor will be 0 volts. So to create negative voltage and enough positive voltage for the op amps, I got this little switch mode converter. And you can, of course, use any of them. It doesn't really matter if it's this one, or you can also come with the voltages from something external. I just had a few of these on stock. And you need to add quite a lot of capacitors and inductors and all that kind of stuff around that converter, because they are very, very noisy. And in this frequency range of hundreds of kilohertz, you cannot have a ripple going around in your circuit, because that will be visible on the oscilloscopes. And we are running very, very fast here, so that means it will interpolate with graphics update speeds and stuff like that. So let's look a little bit on how it looks here on an analog oscilloscope. As you can imagine, it is very, very important to adjust the probe compensation correctly. And I'll show you exactly what's going to happen here. Let me see if I can get in here and show you. See? So this is probe compensation. So that needs to be super duper good. Otherwise you're going to get a little bit of problems. And like you can see here in the T, it's not perfectly right on the horizontal. So of course I need to play with the other probe for horizontal. See? And this also reveals if there's any high speed linearity problems. It's actually quite demanding to show logos like this in perfect straight lines and perfectly round circles and all that kind of stuff. But at least this is what I got. If you look carefully, you can see the little weak lines. That's across the fast movements. And if I crank up the intensity here, see, now what happens here is my camera will change its shutter time, so it's gonna blink a little bit. That's actually weird. But here you see the lines, I guess. It's also very, very bright. It doesn't need to be that bright. But you can see the individual dots, and it's because in this logo I am skipping every second dot just to save bytes on the size of this graphics. Also, what I've done in the software, I've added two extra outputs, not only the analog outputs, but I got digital outputs as well. And if you look at that one, that pin down here that goes onto that probe, it goes to another scope just for fun, so that I can play with the frame time. And it is 155 hertz, the entire frame update with all those many, many dots. And that is because this software here is not the fastest one. I will release a slow one and a fast one on my webpage, and I will put in links in the description of this video. So please go and have a look. You will also find schematics and the software, and also you will find a graphics converter. So let me show you, or let's talk a little bit about how to create the logo. Let's try and create a very, very simple logo. We can do this in CorelDRAW, for example. Let's just make a circle to make it very, very simple, right? So all I do is I make a circle like that, and then I file, export, and here comes the cool thing. What you need to do is you need to select PLT, and then just say yes. That's all you have to do. Okay, here is the HPGL to CSV converter. Remember to get the correct one. This is the 2D version, and this is also available on my webpage. And I will put a link for this file so you can easily find it. So here is the skip factor. This is what you need to input first. Let's put a high value so you'll be able to see how it skips the different dots, or how long it's moving between the dots. And then you select your file. I just saved this one. And here you go. It even shows this circle. If you had different objects with moves, it will actually also show you the different moves here in this little preview. And then it just saved the file called figure onto your download folder. It is that easy. It also shows in a comment how many points your curve consists of. So let's just take this data and then copy, and let's put it into our Arduino project. So here we go. Now we are in my Arduino project. I just left the previous data files in here just so you can easily swap between them. And I'm super lazy to go and change the text of the name of this of this array. So I just put it in here, and then just to make it not show my logo like that. And let's just let's just upload. Thank you very much. And here is, of course, the nice circle. I didn't change the alias capacitors. We can change the size a little bit so it's easier to see what we're doing. But that is how this nice circle looks like with this skip factor that we have chosen. And every time it's done making one full circle, we will have a new little trigger on the frame trigger output here. So it's 1.6 kilohertz update frame speed with a logo that is this symbol, and this is the low speed version. So that is, of course, not blinking at all. And if I crank up the brightness, so my camera will go into fast shutter time. See? No blink at all. So I think this data package is exactly what you need to get started making really nice and funny 2D graphics. And of course, you don't need to use the DA converters I'm using. You can use any other kind of DA converters. You can even use the stereo ones with left, right, and clock and all that kind of stuff. All you have to do is just change a few lines in the code, and the code is also free for your use. Like you see here, there's also a 32-bit version with 3D calculations and real 3D moves and all that kind of cool things. And this is made by Nikolaj, and also the HPGL converter is made by Nikolaj. And I'll put a link in the description, so please go and check this out if you're into 3D. The 3D version is like running only on a 32-bit core, like the ESP32. And this board got internal DA converters. So this is all you need for hardware. And then I just connect the two outputs directly to my oscilloscope. And of course, this is not 0 volts centered. This is offset. So I need to adjust a little bit. But here you go. There's a little bit of funny rounding issues in this software. Maybe that will be fixed in the future. Well, there's also a line in the middle here. I don't know if you can see it. If you really look for it, you can see it when you know it, right? I put the zero here a little bit to the right of this line. And if you look real careful, you can see there is a linearity problem with the DA converter. And this is a known bug in the ESP32 DA section. It is really that bad, or some of them is that bad. There's also another problem with the DMA and the DA converter's updates. You see those tiny little dots that's circling around here. And that is actually the horizontal and the vertical not in perfect update synchronization. So when you change one buffer to another buffer, you will end up having this tiny little dot where it is updating one of the channels before the other one. And we haven't yet figured out exactly how we can keep the two outputs in perfect sync and change buffers and all that kind of stuff. But maybe that will come. We'll see. But the software is available, download it, get it up and running, and try to fix it and send us the updated files. That could be cool.